Hey everyone, Ricky here from Ricky's Tech Talk. In this video, I want to show you how to set up your brand new Huawei MateBook D16 2022 edition. So this model uses Windows 11. Windows 11 was first introduced on the 5th of October 2021. As the year has nearly passed, I thought I'd go through the setup process. Once you've powered your device on, the power button is the top right-hand corner. This is also used as your fingerprint sensor. If you require the use of accessibility settings on your device, such as magnification, narrator, please wait once your device has booted up and it will begin to read these settings available to you.
To set up your device using a screen reader, turn on narrator by pressing Windows and Control and Enter. For more accessibility features, press Windows and U, or select the accessibility icon in the bottom corner.
Make your computer easier to use. Windows will read and scan this list automatically. Press the space bar to select the highlighted option. Narrator. Here on screen text aloud. Magnifier. Make items on the screen larger. On screen keyboard. Type without the keyboard. High contrast. See more contrast in colors. Sticky keys. Filter keys.
It's really important to have those settings available to you right at the beginning. That gives you your independence to set up your own device. So let's continue with our first step. Step 1 is to choose your language. I'm going English, United Kingdom. Step 2 is to select your region. Again, I'm going to choose United Kingdom. Your third step is to select your keyboard layout and input. Again, I'm going to choose the United Kingdom. Your fourth step will ask you, do you want to choose a secondary keyboard setup or layout? I'm going to skip for this process. Step 5 is about connecting to your Wi-Fi network. You'll be provided with a list of different available networks to you. Find your network you use at home or work or school and simply connect. You may need to enter your own password. Step 6 moves on to license agreements. These are terms and conditions you need to read through to use your device. Step 7 is adding some customization to your device, so it's asking you to give a name to your laptop. Step 8 is about adding your Microsoft account, so you need to log in with your Live account or Outlook account. If you don't have one, you can also create one, so just say, I don't have an account, and it will go through the sign up process. If you have an account, simply just sign in now. Step 9 is about adding some protection to your laptop, so you can use your fingerprint to sign in quick and easy and fast, but also adds a level of security. You are then prompted to place your finger on the fingerprint sensor, which is also your power button, that's located the top right hand side of your device. This will fill in the fingerprint image on screen simply by lifting and raising your finger away from the button and simply tapping again. No need to press though. Once this has been fully highlighted on the screen, you can then move on. You will also be prompted to add a key pin as well, so this can be a digit code or a passcode that you can enter every time, just in case the fingerprint reader doesn't read your finger correctly. Step 10 is about choosing a backup, so if you've backed up previously, you can choose to use your backup or you can start completely new. Step 11 is about making some choices for yourself, and these can be a range of different options. So the first one is let Microsoft and its apps use your location, so you can choose to allow or you could choose to disallow. The next option is about Find My Device, so this allows you to track your device wherever you go. You simply log in and see where your device is. Your next choice is to decide if you want to send diagnostic data to Microsoft, so you can choose how much you want to send. It's totally up to you. Your next option is to improve inking and typing, so it'd like to track what you either write on your device, if it's capable, which this device isn't, or your typing. Again, you can choose yes or no. Your next choice is about tailored experience with diagnostic data, and more of a way of advertisement to you. I'm going to say no for this option. Your next option is about letting apps use advertising ID. This is strictly no for myself, but you can choose if you want to be advertised directly or what you're looking at or what you're experiencing with your device. Then it's going to move on and ask about the customization of your device and setting it up for what you want to do. So it may be for work, it may be for school, it may be for pleasure, for entertainment wise, with gaming, movies, music. You can select which options best suit you. Step 12 is about backing up your files to OneDrive. So OneDrive is a subscription-based service from Microsoft, so you can choose to use this if you want to. It's also included in Office 365 as well. You may get a free trial with your device. Once you choose to either accept or deny the Office 365 trial, this will bring the setup process to a complete. Your device will restart and then will load with a new Windows 11 theme. So Windows 11 has completely changed and it's really intuitive now. There's loads of different changes and options that you can adjust to customize your device to the way you want to use it. It's fully accessible and gives you the ability to change and adjust the settings to make it most accessible to you. If you have any questions or you want to share your thoughts, make sure to leave a comment below and I will make sure to reply as soon as I can. I hope you found this video helpful and I will be sharing more videos on the Huawei MateBook D16 2022. Make sure to check out my unboxing and my first thoughts here, and my review will be coming very soon. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure to subscribe today and tap the notification bell to be updated once I share new videos. For me, Ricky, thank you for watching and have a great day.